Welcome to the Corel tutorial on understanding transparencies in PaintShop Pro. Creating transparencies in an image editing program means having the ability to set up part of your image to be invisible and see-through. Transparency is usually, but not always, used to delete a white background from clip art, a logo, or something similar. It can be also used to create windows in which to place other images inside, such as pictures, within frames. The following examples of transparencies are fairly simple in that they don't include any varied degrees of transparency, such as gradient mask, nor do they support color blending between layers, such as an alpha channel, and they use some of the easiest to use tools in PaintShop Pro. The idea is that parts are either visible or they're not. We'll cover collage frames, single picture frames, and transparent web objects. Before we begin, if you're watching this video on YouTube, you can pause it and click on the link in the description below to go to the tutorial page and download a written copy of this tutorial and follow along. PaintShop Pro has many pre-built included templates and objects that can be used in transparency projects that you can add your own photos into. You've just seen a few examples of photo editing projects that make use of basic transparency. If you go to File, New from Template, you can open up something similar to this multi-frame collage template. Let's take a look around and learn more about the features of transparencies. The first things to note is the gray and white checkerboard background in each of the small picture frames. This is a common indication of a transparency. In PaintShop Pro, this look can be customized. Go to File, Preferences, General Program Preferences, then to Transparency and Shading. Such items as grid size and color scheme can be selected from this list. Even grid colors can be changed. Click OK or Cancel once you're finished with your changes, if any. Let's place a couple photos into these frames. It's very easy. I have two photos that have already been sized to fit this frame. I'll go to one of them, select the hand tool, right-click on the image, and copy. Then I'll go to the collage template, right-click, and choose Paste, Paste as New Layer. Select the pick tool and move it over one of the picture frames. You notice it's currently on top of the frame. In order to put it into the frame, you just rearrange the layer so the photo is in back of the frame, and bingo. I'll do it again with another photo. PaintShop Pro also has many included single picture frames, which you can get by downloading the free bonus content. Just like the collage frame, these also have transparent parts built in. With this robin's egg image open, I'll go to Image, Picture Frame, and choose the bird's frame. I'm also going to choose Frame Outside the Image, and click Keep Transparent, and click OK. Notice that not only do you see the bird's eggs through the frame's transparency, but the layer representing this frame has a checkerboard background, indicating the center area and the area outside the frame are transparent. In PaintShop Pro, you may also use a preset shape to create a transparency. Here's an example of the result of drawing out a heart-shaped object on top of a photo. Using the Shape Cutter tool, it will auto-crop the images into your shape without having to set up and use layers. Notice that this is a PNG file, not a JPEG. PNGs support transparency and JPEGs do not. I recommend viewing the short tutorial on using the shape cutter. One of the most popular uses of transparency, especially for businesses, is on web pages. One of the most common web uses is to place an image on a web page so that the web page's background becomes your image's background, such as a play button on a YouTube video poster frame, or your logo, or a product shot on your homepage. Let's go to the Corel website and show you a couple of examples. You notice the PaintShop Pro box shot here. If I right-click on it, you'll see that it is an image because I can save it as an image. I'll just grab it and put it on my desktop. Then I'll drag and drop it right into PaintShop Pro. You can tell this image is part transparent when you look at the layer and see the checkerboard pattern. If we go to the Corel Discovery Center, I can point out that all these video play buttons on this page are also transparent and were merged with the underlying images. The play button is not really functional as the entire image is a hyperlink, but it does indicate that it's clickable. You can also create more complex transparencies using items such as selection tools, eraser tools, including the special background eraser tools, and masks and alpha channels, where you can even create various degrees of transparency. Here are some examples of these. We won't cover the step-by-step workflow for these projects now, but you can find links on the tutorial page for more transparency tutorials. I mentioned this briefly already, but it's very important to know what file formats will support transparencies, because not all do so. The most common format that supports it is PNG, which we've used here. GIF and JPEG 2000 are also compatible. Regular JPEGs do not support transparency. Once you finish merging all your images into the final one, you can still save it as a JPEG for sharing, but to be put on a web page, and unless blending with a background is not necessary, you'll want to save it as a PNG. So that's a good overview of transparency, what's possible, and the many different ways they can be created. If you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here you can download a written copy of this tutorial to follow along, and find other helpful tutorials for working with transparencies in PaintShop Pro.